Traitor McCain just came out of cancer recovery to screw Americans again by being deciding vote 2 months ago. The American people had the chance to repeal the monstrosity known as Obamacare. Instead of the disastrous bill being sent packing, Senator John McCain voted against the repeal that left conservatives reeling. Everyone wondered what could prompt the senator from Arizona to vote against the will of the people. Many speculated that it was his hatred for President Trump that spurred the deciding vote or his devotion to helping destroy America. Whatever McCain's reason was at that time doesn't matter now, since his vote again is the deciding factor in the latest last-ditch effort by Republicans to repeal and replace Obamacare. During President Trump's campaign, he made a promise to get rid of Obamacare, but that has been easier said than done. Every which way he has turned, the sneaky RINOs in Washington D.C. have thrown roadblocks in his way. One of those is no other than Senator John McCain, and it appears that he is doing his best to stump Trump and his agenda. In late July, the American people were thrilled at the prospect of Obamacare being dismantled. However, as you know, that didn't happen. In a stunning yet not surprising move, McCain voted against the repealing and replacement of Obamacare. Now, the Republicans in the Senate are attempting to repeal and replace Obamacare one last time before the September 30th deadline. However, it faces significant challenges, one of them being Senator John McCain and a few others that could stop the bill from being passed. The bill that has been drafted by Senators Lindsey Graham of South Carolina and Bill Cassidy of Louisiana would replace the Affordable Care Act's insurance subsidies with block grants to states. Here is more from the Hill. Congress has 12 days to say yes to Graham Cassidy. It's time for them to get the job done, he said, referring to the bill's two main co-sponsors, Senators Lindsey Graham, RS.C. and Bill Cassidy, RLock. Ducey's support is important because Senator John McCain, R. Arizona, has said the Arizona governor's position would be an important factor in how he votes. McCain helped kill the repeal effort in July, calling for committee hearings and a bipartisan process, but he has left the door open to voting for Graham and Cassidy's bill. Still, McCain on Monday criticized the rushed process leading up to a possible vote next week, while not ruling out voting for the bill. The governor of Arizona is favorably inclined, but I am going to have a lot more information, McCain said. He reiterated his call for committee hearings and amendments, known as regular order. We should be going through regular order, he said. I've said that about 12 times. Senator Lisa Murkowski, R. Alaska, another crucial vote, also said Monday she is still studying the impacts on her state. Senate GOP leadership is becoming more engaged. A source who has spoken to Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell's, RKY, office described him as taking it very seriously. The leader asked CBO to prioritize the score on the legislation, said McConnell spokesman David Popp. We expect regular staff briefings and member discussions to continue. Senate Majority Whip John Cornyn, R. Texas, last week said he is conducting a whip count to gauge the level of support for the bill, though he did not say he would be pushing for it. A significant factor giving the measure new momentum is a fast-approaching September 30 deadline. At the end of the month, Republicans will not be able to use rules known as budget reconciliation to bypass a Democratic filibuster in the Senate. If the measure can be filibustered, it has no chances of passing the Senate. As a result, Republicans are feeling pressure to move quickly to enact change they have long promised but have been unable to deliver, even with their party in control of Congress and the White House. The last-ditch effort is expected to have the backing of most Republican senators, but there are some high-profile holdouts. Senator Rand Paul, RKY, has been tweeting his opposition to the bill, saying it keeps too much of Obamacare. Senator Susan Collins, R. Maine, who voted against previous repeal efforts, has also said she has concerns and is expected to be a no vote. McCain has not endorsed the bill, though the fact that his close friend Graham is a co-sponsor has many observers thinking that he could be brought on board. If McCain backs the bill and Paul maintains his opposition, that could leave Murkowski as the deciding vote. Murkowski voted against every version of a repeal bill in July. Murkowski told reporters Monday she is still studying the bill and its impact on Alaska. The obvious question that everyone is asking is, will Senator McCain screw the American people again by voting against this bill? It is anyone's guess, but let's not hold our breath thinking that he will do right by America. This man has done all he can to support the Democrats' sinister plan to destroy the country, and his latest comments do nothing to calm those fears. We can only hope and pray that he will hear our voices loud and clear and vote to repeal and replace Obamacare once and for all. Share if you are sick of Senator John McCain working against the American people.